Over the last 10 years, we've had the good fortune of spending 9 months in Mexico and 9 months in Costa Rica. My name's Aaron, this is Plan Free. Today we're gonna talk to you about, in our experience, what we found the differences to be between Costa Rica and Mexico. As mentioned, this video we're gonna focus on what we perceive the differences between these two countries to be. So we're gonna skip over many of the similarities between the two. In the cases of beaches, climate, spoken languages, we're not gonna spend any time on those items, and we're gonna focus in on some of the things that you can compare one to the other. If you'd like to help out and support the channel for free, go ahead and press the like button, click subscribe and the blue bell icon so you always know when our next video is coming out. Let's begin on a subject that we think almost everyone is interested in, food. In the case of Costa Rica, the food is going to be fairly simple as compared to Mexico. In Costa Rica, you'll find many fine food options, but a good portion of the time, the best food options are restaurants that are owned by foreigners. Local Costa Rica cuisine isn't as famous or as known as, let's say, Mexican cuisine is. And in our experience, the typical Costa Rican cuisine is fairly limited in its offerings, variety, and flavors. When you compare that with Mexico, the phrase Mexican food is a universally understood and sought after food offering, and a lot of people like it. So when you're in Mexico, you're most often seeking out local type food in Mexican restaurants. For a change of pace, you might go out to a foreign-owned establishment, but most of the time, you're perfectly fine eating authentic Mexican food for the entire duration of your stay. We find Mexican food to have a wider variety and flavor palette than, say, Costa Rican food by comparison. The next difference between the two countries of Mexico and Costa Rica would have to be wildlife. Now, even though Mexico is not necessarily known for its wildlife as compared to Costa Rica, Mexico is a huge and diverse country, and they do definitely have wildlife. They especially excel in the variety of bird life they have. But in a video like this, comparing the two countries, Mexico just cannot compete directly with Costa Rica in the area of wildlife. Specifically, Costa Rica is going to excel in the larger wildlife and the prevalence of. In our experience in Costa Rica, you can walk around both urban and jungle settings and you're very likely, most likely, to see monkeys. In Mexico, that's just simply not going to be the case. The closest thing you'll see to wildlife in many Mexican towns would be dogs. In addition to monkeys, Costa Rica has the good fortune of many additional large species of wildlife, in the form of sloths, alligators, anteaters, and on and on. In the case of wildlife specifically, Costa Rica definitely has the wider array. In the past 10 years of living a geographically independent lifestyle, my wife and I have primarily been enjoying a style of travel known as slow travel, where we stay the majority of our locations 3 to 6 months at a time. And as such, these next couple of things we're gonna discuss will be most interesting to people that are staying for longer periods of time in their chosen destinations. Cost of living. The cost of living will be higher in Costa Rica, generally speaking, as it would be compared to Mexico. Now, each country will have towns and locations that will have higher cost of livings than other. A general rule is the more tourists and expats that are in whatever region you've chosen, the higher the cost of living will be. Conversely, if you find yourself in areas that have very little to no expats or tourists, you're gonna find your cost of living decreasing. Having said that, generally speaking across the board, Mexico is going to have a lower cost of living than Costa Rica. In conjunction with Mexico's lower cost of living, I would say another benefit would be that they have a wider array of products and services available to the consumer. Maybe because their proximity to the United States, but if you like to have some of the comforts of home, Mexico is certainly going to offer you more of those than Costa Rica will. Okay, sticking with some items that might be more important to a slow traveler, let's talk about standard visa stay options that each country will grant you. Now, I'll be talking from the perspective of a Canadian, but I would say that most of the first world countries, USA included, Australia, UK, etc., will have similar parameters in what's being offered to citizens of these countries. As of the time of this recording, Costa Rica offers Canadians a 90-day hassle-free visa stay, which coincidentally is about the minimum hassle-free visa stay that we at Plan Free like to look for. So again, we're looking to stay in a location for probably a minimum of 3 months, but more often 6 months. And this is where Mexico really excels at the moment. Mexico offers Canadians a hassle-free visa stay of 180 days. Now, we're recording this video in November of 2021, and we have been hearing recently that the standard visa stays given out to Canadians and Americans, etc., is beginning to become shorter. We're actually leaving for Mexico for what we hope is 6 months here very shortly. So potentially we'll give you an update on the visas and what kind of stays are being granted to first world country citizens in the current environment. If any of you out there have recent experiences with visa stays, whether it be in Costa Rica or Mexico, go ahead and add your experience in the comments below this video. Military presence. You're going to see a stark contrast between the two countries when it comes to this item. In Mexico, it's quite common to see fully armed military personnel in your daily travels, especially if you're staying in larger cities. You'll see them walking the streets, driving around in trucks, all heavily armed with machine guns. This can be intimidating even for those of us that have spent months at a time in the country. You do get somewhat used to it over time. I'd prefer it not to be the case, but if it's something that bothers you, you'll definitely note it as a negative in Mexico. Conversely, you might be the personality where this doesn't bother you at all. Compare that to Costa Rica, where Costa Rica does not even have an organized military. You'll be able to walk up and down the streets and never experience heavily armed people in your stay in Costa Rica. We would count this as a decided benefit to spending time in Costa Rica. What are some of the differences that you've noticed between these two countries that we didn't touch on? Add them in the comments below. As you continue to compare the differences between countries, we recommend you watch this video next. If you'd like to help and support the channel, you can press the like button for free. It just takes a second and it helps a lot. Press the subscribe button and the blue bell icon so you always know when the next video is coming out.